In the late 1970s, the Chateau Theater in Rochester, Minnesota, caused a conflict between two different parties, preservationists and developers. In 1993, the Rochester City Council agreed that a bookstore would be the best compromise of the space. Barnes & Noble opened there a year later.
Hundreds watched as Dr. Charles Mayo turned the dirt at the site of the future Chateau Theater for downtown Rochester. Built in 1927, this theater was filled with miraculous designs and moldings. I.H. Rubin, owner of the theater at the time, said, "We have given this town the finest theater of its size, bar none, in the U.S. Unfortunately, this attraction could not last. In 1979, Plitt Theaters Company gave up ownership of the theater. Now the theater is up for grabs."
Northwest Bank planned to demolish the theater and open an establishment in Rochester. When this happened, the citizens of Rochester took action. They formed a group, Friends of the Chateau.
President or vice president of the bank, developer, some other financial groups were there, and the architect was there, and they were getting entrenched saying this building will fall. And they said, I said, why? And they said, well, we need the footprint. We need all of that land to make this building work. And I said, would you be willing to listen to an option that you haven't considered? And I said this to the architect. And I said, what's that? And I said, what if you could get the square footage that you wanted free? They said, well, that would be interesting, and how would you propose we do that? I said, well, you have not looked at all of your options. I said, how about taking your building and crossing First Avenue over this free land space that is public and tie it into the Kaler, and you've just made your building much more valuable, and yet you're also going to get the square footage that you need to make this facility work.
Apparently, Rochester's historic buildings were more important to its citizens than a banking establishment. But even though all this, the Chateau story was unfinished.
Nicholas Pathelis bought the theater in the 1983 auction after the Northwest Banking Establishment was built somewhere else. Plan to renovate the Chateau as a mall or rent it as office spaces, borrowing $1.4 million from First Bank Rochester.
And he lost ownership of that. He couldn't. He couldn't continue to reduce the debt in the fashion so that he lost it, and then it was up for grabs.
Pathless had a debt of $565,000 because of loans to renovate the theater, but still, it wasn't enough. He went to court, suing his lender for not supplying adequate funds. Pathless lost his case. Loans swelled to $690,000. First Bank took Pathless to court with claims that Pathless couldn't pay back his loans.
We expect that, if they do appeal, the decision will be affirmed.
Said First Bank attorney Craig Beck, Nicholas Pathless lost ownership of the Chateau and his restaurant, Nick Ribs.
Obviously, we're interested in the appearance of it.
Said Rochester City Administrator Stephen Venvold.
We have spent a lot of time and expense in downtown redevelopment, and the plaza looks quite nice, except for this particular building.
The city council is making plans for the newly vacant theater.
I think we're going to have some idea of what use the building might be and the cost of getting it there before we can seriously consider acquisition. We expect the bank to be talking to us and others.
The Chateau Theater was safe once again. Once again it was saved. But once again, it was an empty shell. Its true potential and fate undiscovered. It is clear this cannot last.
After many struggles, the Chateau Theater found a compromise.
On June 3, 1993, the word was released that the former Chateau Theater was planned to become a bookstore.
I can't believe we wouldn't be awfully enthused about this project.
Said a Downtown Development Advisory Board member, Chuck Pappas.
and I think we should support it all we can.
Member Chubb Stewart claimed that other people interested in restoring the Chateau as a performing arts center have had years to do so. The theater has been closed for over a decade.
Only one member, Cynthia Dobb, expressed dismay at the rest of the board, for she wanted the Chateau as a performing arts center.
I would criticize the city council, not the Schifolius companies, for coming forward with this, because I'm as pleased as heck that the building will be restored. But it's a humiliation for the building to become a bookstore instead of a jewel of a performing arts center. The city has failed to provide a decent music hall, and the Chateau would have been perfect.
Barnes & Noble booksellers would be the tenants of the building. Business would be good, as it would be connected to the rest of the downtown plaza. Developer Gus Trifolius estimated that this project would cost $3.3 million, about one-fifth of which would come from taxpayer expenses. The city generated about $1,000 in taxes from this building every year, but this was expected to quadruple if the redevelopment succeeded.
However, the competition did spark anger in some. Rita Lynch, owner of the Little Professor Books in the downtown Skyway, had to comment.
I'm extremely upset with the city of Rochester for getting involved in this operation that puts our business in extreme jeopardy.
Nevertheless, Barnes & Noble opened in August 1994, keeping all of the original marquee intact. This is where it stands today. The Chateau Theater truly is art. It has stood the test of time. Nobody wanted this to fade away. Every town has a Chateau Theater. Let's hope yours turns out as well as this one did.